What's going on, everybody? It's Yam, but with a deeper voice. Puberty, finally! Just kidding. It's your favorite cruiser boy, Spite, bringing that nice, smooth, calming voice to offset that highly caffeinated yeet energy you're so used to. Today, we're going to be talking about the best beginner motorcycles for tall riders. Now, here's the thing. If you're between 5'10" and 6'3", pretty much every bike will fit you. Some bikes, like Groms, might not be the most comfortable, but you can definitely make it work, as I demonstrated in the Grom battle video. You should definitely check that video out too. It was a ton of fun to make. But the point remains, you can hop on basically anything. However, I noticed that motorcyclists are vain creatures. I've never tried to catch my own reflection more than when I'm on my bike, and nothing looks worse than that bear on a tricycle look. So today, I decided to throw together a list of the 7 best starter bikes for those tall boys out there looking to get onto wheels. Before we hop in though, I need to take a second and thank our sponsor for today's video, Rockform. We've been talking a lot about them lately, and there's a good reason. Gone are the days of bulky RAM mounts blocking your view of the dash, or quad locks holding your phone on your bike with all the vagueness of a politician on the campaign trail. It's time for you to get the best motorcycle phone mount and case combo out there. Rockform cases are made out of super durable materials that are drop tested, and they fit pretty much every phone you can get, except those old Nokia brick phones. But let's be honest, if you drop one of those, you're more likely to dent the earth than the phone. The mount is super low profile, so it won't block your view, and with a phone safe magnet, it won't let go of your phone when you hit a pothole. If you click the link down below and use the code YN25, you'll get 25% off your order. Thanks again to Rockform for supporting our shenanigans, and if you like what we do, please support those who help us out. Now let's get to these bikes. Now, I didn't want to cop out and include a bunch of larger displacement borderline beginner motorcycles, something like, say, a VFR 800. So as a rule today, pretty much every bike on this list will be safe for anyone getting ready to start out, regardless of their experience, and the first bike on today's list is the DRZ 400 SM. Yep, number 7 goes to the bike that has had me so frustrated I've felt like filling the gas tank with Tannerite and dropping it off of a cliff. Now, don't let my woes with my personal DRZ 400 discourage you. I just happened to buy the crustiest one in Texas because it was dirt cheap. Most DRZs that I've seen in the used market are in much, much better shape. But what about the bike specifically? Well, the DRZ 400 SM is the factory supermoto version of the DRZ 400S, which means it comes with 17-inch wheels that are about 1,000 times better for carving up corners than the 21-18-inch wheel combo on the S model. It makes 39.7 horsepower and 28.8 foot-pounds of torque out of its 398cc single-cylinder engine, and from personal experience, that torque comes on real quick and makes it a blast to ride. It's not a fast bike, it doesn't have a sixth gear in the transmission, but its 321-pound wet weight makes it quick off the line, and it'll happily lope down the highway at 60 or 70 miles per hour. Also, since it's based on a dual sport, the suspension offers a ton of adjustability, which is great for heavier riders. So if you're a taller rider looking for a bike that can get you down a dirt road or the back straight of your local track, the DRZ 400 SM is your bike. Number 6 goes to the Kawasaki Vulcan S, and rejoice, Vulcan boys, I'm about to praise your bike for the first time. The Kawasaki Vulcan is a great option for tall riders looking to get into a cruiser bike simply because of how modular it is. Kawasaki has made this bike capable of fitting basically anyone from Tom Cruise to Yao Ming thanks to their Ergo Fit package. It's not exactly rocket science, but they have offered a ton of different parts, from pegs that are farther away from the rider to taller seats, even lowered bars, so you can tailor your fit. And it's not just for taller folks. They have a bunch of stuff for the vertically challenged people out there. So rest assured, if you're 6'4" with a 26-inch inseam, the Vulcan S will have you covered. The best part is that it's no slouch either. With the 649cc parallel twin from the Ninja 650, the bike makes 61 horsepower and 46.5 foot-pounds of torque. Now, I'm not the biggest fan of this particular engine. I think it's a little boring, but everyone who's ridden a Vulcan says it's quick, nimble, and feels light despite its 492-pound wet weight. It's a great package for beginners, including standard ABS, a simple dash that tells you everything you need to know, and Big 4 reliability, all for $7,099. But what if you're feeling a cruiser and definitely need to buy American? Well, this might come as a shock to some of you out there, but number 5 is actually going to go to the Indian Scout 60.
Finally, he's realized there's other cruisers coming out of America!
And yeah, I wanted to put the Sportsters here, but the price combined with the weight and the way the 1200s make their power is a little tough for a beginner. By contrast, the Indian Scout 60 makes 78 horsepower and 65.5 foot-pounds of torque. Damn, Spike, isn't that a lot for a beginner? And yeah, it is the bleeding edge of what I would consider a beginner cruiser, but I'm okay saying that you can start on this bike because it really isn't awake at lower RPM. Because it's tuned more for power over torque, it needs to be wrung out for you to really feel it. Also, it weighs in at 565 pounds wet, so it's not exactly going to get out of its own way. The Scout features a 999cc V-twin, forward pegs, classic American cruiser vibes, and costs only $9,000. When you compare that to the Iron 883, which is heavier, slower, and costs the same, really isn't much of a comparison. It handles really well, too, since it's based on the Indian Scout frame. The only major difference is a little less punch and only 5 gears in the gearbox. Okay, so you're tall and you want to go fast. Well, sport bikes are one of the toughest class of bikes for taller riders to get into, which sucks because they're one of the most easily recognizable profiles, and who doesn't love the sound of an R1 banging off gears? Well, my pick for a sport bike in the beginner class, and number 4 on today's list, is Honda's CBR500R. I'm genuinely confused as to why more people don't talk about this bike. For a tall beginner, I couldn't think of a better sport bike. Sure, it's got more in common with a Versus 650 than an RC213V, but it has all the looks of a sport bike, and you're actually gonna fit on it. I spent the day at a dealership when we were picking up our last round of giveaway bikes, which there's 6 of them now up for grabs. The R1, SV650, MT03, Svartpillen 401, and 2 Groms. If you want to enter to win, you gotta click the link in the description down below. You've never had a better chance. But anyway, I spent a lot of time looking at the sport bike offerings for beginners, and the only one that fit me out of all of them was the CBR500R. It's got a pokey little 471cc parallel twin engine making 50 horsepower and 31.7 foot-pounds of torque, which when combined with its 419 pounds wet makes it a surprisingly quick little bike. It'll dust up a Ninja 400, RC390, and R3 all day and look damn fine doing it. You can get it in the black and red or red and white colorways like the Big Brother Fireblades, and it comes with that classic Honda build quality. This is the kind of beginner sport bike that you can have for more than your first 6 months of riding, thanks to that extra displacement. But at $6,699, it's a little on the pricey side, but it's worth it if you ask me. So we've seen a dual sport, 2 cruisers, and a sport bike, but what if you fancy yourself the long way round type? You want a motorcycle that looks like it can tackle Dakar, the Road of Bones, and a trip down to your local Starbucks? Well, there's really only one option, the BMW G310GS. Yep, number 3 goes to the baby GS, German engineering with an accessible price. You might think that a 313cc single packed into a little ADV package would make for a diminutive bike, but go stand next to one. These bikes feature a 32.8-inch seat height, which is almost enough to have me standing on tiptoes at 6'3". The baby GS makes 34 horsepower and 20.7 foot-pounds of torque, which is not bad, and the 373-pound wet weight means that it'll get up and go. The best part of this bike has to be the looks, though. I mean, admit it, we've all looked at the bikes that Ewan and Charlie took around the world and thought to ourselves, man, that looks badass. But in no world should a beginner be hopping on a shiny new 1250 GS. Even the F800 is a little much for a beginner, but now you can have all the looks and feel of a big BMW ADV bike for only $5,695. That's cheap enough that pretty much anyone can go grab one brand spanking new. Not to mention our camera wizard Andrew has one with a slip-on, and it sounds really mean. Now don't get me wrong, it's not all sunshine and rainbows. There are some budget parts, like all beginner bikes, but if you want to look down your nose at your friends on Japanese motorcycles like a true Euro bro, then this is the only way to do it. Number 2 on the list goes to those folks out there that know there's nothing better than riding quick and popping dank nooners naked. No, not like that. I mean on a naked bike. like. I mean, I've had windburn on my knee from my ripped jeans. I wouldn't even want to imagine what windburn on my nethers would feel like. But back on topic. The best naked bike for tall beginners has to go to the XSR 700, and I'm not just saying that because we gave one away in our last round of giveaways. It's genuinely a great motorcycle for a tall rider. It's really comfortable to ride for an all-day stretch. It features a 32.9-inch seat height, which is pretty darn tall in the world of naked bikes, and swept-back handlebars with a long, flat seat so you can stretch out while you ride. And it's quick as hell to boot. We've talked about it at length before, so here's the short version. It has a 689cc cross-plane parallel twin that makes 74 horsepower and 50 foot-pounds of torque, and it weighs 410 pounds wet. This means that the bike is light, fast, and has a very unique sound that you don't normally get out of parallel twins. I also love how moddable it is. There's basically nothing on the bike you can't change. From cafe racers to flat track scramblers to Twins Cup race bikes, the XSR MT07 platform has done it all, and it's not a bike that you're going to grow out of too quick either. In fact, I would really only recommend the XSR 700 for a first time rider that's a little older and can be a little bit more responsible, because it can be a handful. The worst part about this bike is that it costs way too much brand new at $8,499, but you can get them on the cheaper side if you do your homework. Now, number one on our list today is your bike. And this might sound a little confusing or like a bit of a cop-out, but at the end of the day, you should be buying the bike that you want. I can stand here and tell you that your bike might be too small for you, but if you like it, who cares? I owned a Harley-Davidson Street Rod, which is specifically designed for men and women under 6 foot tall, and my ride was definitely a little cramped, but I still loved it. Hell, even now and again, I take it out for a spin and am reminded about how much fun it was. Sure, I moved on to other bigger bikes, but I still rode that Street Rod for over a year. I made a few key changes that made it more comfortable, but none of them are bike specific. A tall seat, lower pegs, and higher handlebars will basically go on any motorcycle. If you want to start on an RC390 and you're concerned about your size, I would say just do it. Wrenching and modding your bike to make it yours is one of the most fun things you can do, and aside from swapping an exhaust or tuning your bike, changing your ergonomic setup is one of the most instantly noticeable and rewarding mods you can do. So just go get the bike you want and go for a ride, my dude.
So my sweet little squid, this video is actually over, but lucky for you, click on this one right here. You can keep watching your sweet Papa Yam delivering you the motorcycle content you've come to know and love. Don't worry, I'll wait. I'll be here waiting for you. You're gonna click on that video.